Bill Bruford talks about his brief stint in the band Genesis. I'm John Beaudin from Rock History Music. Even I sometimes forget that Bill Bruford was in the band Genesis as a touring member in 1976. It was a sort of a transitionary time for the band, but I asked him how it all came about.
Well, it's a very brief story that I've said a few times, and it was right around the time that Peter Gabriel was leaving the band. I was hanging out with Phil Collins in his kind of fusion group, playing percussion to his drums. We were backstage at some place, and he was saying, "We've got a problem. This guy, Peter Gabriel, is leaving. We've been auditioning singers to replace him, and they're all terrible." And Phil said, "I think I could probably do as well as any of those guys." And so I think I probably made the obvious connection and said, "Well, why don't you do that? I'll play the." He knew my drumming. "I'll play the drums for a 9 months or a year or something. See until you're comfortable. Make sure you want to do it full time, and then I'll get off the bus, and you can get someone else, and I'll get on my merry way." And it was as simple as that.
I always found it kind of weird people giving Phil flack, Phil Collins, because I always thought he was an amazing drummer.
Yeah, Phil's a tremendously rhythmic guy, a great dancer, great mover, a great mimic too. Funnily enough, I mean, if you heard him imitating a sea lion, flapping his hands together and barking in the way sea lions do, I swear you would think a sea lion had entered the room. Now, he can do the same thing on a drum kit, so he can imitate Ringo. He could imitate Billy Cobham, for heaven's sake. It wasn't necessarily Phil's drumming itself, but it was somebody else's idea, really, but he could play it. He could nail it right away. So he was a very talented guy, no doubt about that at all. And I'm disappointed now that he seems to be an unhappy guy. Some of that's physical, I think. I think he has a lot of physical problems.
I know you were on the Genesis Revisited album that Steve Hackett put together. What was it like touring with Steve in Genesis?
Oh, Steve was the guitarist in the band. I don't have any strong stories there, okay. John. I wish I could, but I really don't. I mean, bear in mind, it was only a 9-month tour with Genesis. Yes. So we didn't create any new music together. And that's the key difference between musicians. You know, are you on a tour in a band that's doing heritage thing where there will be no new music written and arranged and produced? That's easy. Much harder is inventing and collaborating in a collective that's arranging new music. That's much harder. So I never did that. And that's when you get to know people, of course. And of course, I didn't do that with Steve, so I don't really know him very well at all.
Two more segments for Bill Bruford, 2 more weeks. We'll have more from him coming up next Saturday. Make sure you comment on our videos, subscribe to our channel, and share our videos. I'm John Beaudin from Rock History Music.